In this video, we consider circumstances where legislation is created in the form of subordinate legislation, i.e. ministerial regulations, and whether or not the creation of those ministerial regulations as a type of conduct might be administrative or legislative conduct. And we do that primarily with reference to the new clicks decision. So the new clicks decision was about a challenge to regulations created by the Minister of Health back in 2004 to regulate the pricing of medicines sold by pharmacies. And new clicks was not happy with the medicine pricing regulations and wanted to take them on review. And one of the big questions was whether new clicks should challenge the minister's conduct in making the regulations on the grounds of PUDJA and Section 33 of the Constitution, or whether the principle of legality was applicable. And that issue turned on whether or not the minister's conduct was administrative in nature. In other words, whether the minister, in making regulations, had taken a decision of an administrative nature. And this is a very troublesome case because, as you know, there are 11 judges in the Constitutional Court who considered this issue, and no clear precedent emerged from the judgment. And so you had some judges say, yes, the making of ministerial regulations is administrative in nature, and you have some judges saying sometimes the making of ministerial regulations will be administrative in nature, but not other times, and some judges not making a finding on this issue at all. And so last year, one of my students made a meme about this, which I'll share with you now, which very accurately describes the position after the new clicks decision. And what the meme says is, when the court says creating ministerial regulations can be admin action all the time, except not all the time, but sometimes, but not also never, always sometimes. And you have Mr. Krabs being very, very confused. So that is the position, literally, as pictured, that emerged from the new clicks decision. And let me just go back to our slides. And that's because you had, first of all, Judge Chaskelson and Judge Lange and Judge O'Regan finding that the creation of ministerial regulations would always amount to administrative action. Then you have Judge Noble and Judge van der Westhuizen finding that the creation of some but not all regulations would amount to administrative action. And then you have Sachs finding that sometimes the enactment of regulations would amount to administrative action, but sometimes not, and one had to consider the impact of the regulations. He said if, once enacted, the regulations were of a general impact, they would not be administrative in nature, but if they had a specific impact, they would become administrative action. The remaining justices declined to decide whether or not the creation of ministerial regulations amounted to administrative action. And in light of all of these conflicting views in the new clicks case, there is no clear indication from the Constitutional Court whether or not the creation of ministerial regulations amounts to a decision of an administrative nature and is thus administrative action. All that new clicks tells us is that the creation of ministerial regulations might amount to administrative action. And subsequent cases have treated the creation of ministerial regulations as administrative in nature, based on Chaskelson's reasoning, but others have simply applied legality and left the question as to whether the creation of ministerial regulations is administrative in nature or not open. And so it's quite a mess, in other words. If we go back to our slides on this matter and just discuss a subsequent case where the court left the matter open. So in the very recent case of Minister of Mineral Resources versus Stern, a 2019 case, the matter was about a challenge to the validity of the regulations for petroleum exploration and production 2015, also known as the petroleum regulations. Now, these regulations were intended to enhance the regime regulating proposed hydraulic fracturing activities in the Karoo. And hydraulic fracturing is a very controversial practice because around the world it's been criticized as being very fossil fuel intensive and causing very problematic water pollution in the areas that it happens. What happens with hydraulic fracturing is that a very deep hole of about 5 kilometers is drilled into the ground, and then the drill goes horizontally across the ground, and then water that is contaminated is pumped into the hole and under very high pressure, and the ground is fractured, and the fracturing of the ground so deep allows natural gases to escape from underground and be captured above ground. But in that fracturing process, there are concerns about contaminating underground water and polluting water tables. So it's a controversial practice, and the government wanted to put in place additional regulations to ensure that the risks of hydraulic fracturing could be addressed through regulation. And the Minister of Mineral Resources purported to promulgate the petroleum regulations and purported to do so in terms of Section 107 of the Minerals and Petroleum Resources Development Act. And there was a challenge against the regulations on the grounds that the minister didn't have the power under the Minerals and Petroleum Resources Development Act to make the regulations. It was argued that the proper minister to make the regulations was the Minister of Environmental Affairs, who was empowered under different legislation to enhance the regime governing something like hydraulic fracturing. And the court actually agreed with this argument and the idea that the Minister of Environmental Affairs was the authorized administrator and that the Mineral Resources Minister did not have the power to act and had therefore acted outside of his powers. And so, having found that the Minister of Mineral Resources was not empowered to make the regulations, the court concluded the regulations were made unlawfully. But we know that the court should have answered the question, what is the proper basis to challenge these regulations? Is the proper basis, on the one hand, PUDGA? Is the proper pathway to review the regulations PUDGA? Or is the proper pathway to review the regulations legality? And this is what the court had to say about that. The court declined to decide whether PUDGA applied to a challenge to the making of the petroleum regulations. And the court referred to this as an antecedent question. And that's wrong. The question of the proper basis to review public power is a primary question. And we know that with reference to the article that I wrote with Werner van Westhuizen on the principle of subsidiarity. So the court should have made a finding on this issue, and instead the court said it doesn't matter and avoided the question of the applicability of PUDGA. And what that really confirms is that there's still a great deal of uncertainty about the proper basis to review the creation of ministerial regulations, because we don't know if that conduct is administrative or legislative in nature. In the next video, we're going to distinguish between administrative and executive conduct and work out when conduct that might at first glance appear to be executive in nature could nonetheless be administrative in nature and regulated by Paja.